Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the topic internal combustion engines. So this is lecture number 17 on internal combustion engine. So we are going to solve problems in the internal combustion engine. So we recap. The earlier two lecture also we solved problems. So here again we are going to solve few more questions from Anna University question paper. And at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems in the IC engine. And we take the example number 14 from November 2014 question paper. A 21 cm bore and 28 cm stroke single cylinder two stroke engine gives the following results on the performance test. Speed 350 rpm, net brake load 620 newton, diameter of the brake drum 1 meter, fuel consumption 4.25 kg per hour, IMEP indicated mean effective pressure 275 kN per meter square, calorific value of the fuel 43,000 kJ per kilogram, air fuel ratio by weight 32, temperature of air in the test room 15 degree Celsius, temperature of the exhaust gases 370 degree Celsius, calculate indicated power, brake power, indicated thermal efficiency, brake thermal efficiency and percentage heat loss in the exhaust gases. So we write down the given data, diameter equal to 0.21 meter, stroke length equal to 0.28 meter, number of cylinder K equal to 1, it is a two stroke cycle engine. Speed equal to 350 rpm, load on the brake drum 620 newton, diameter of the brake drum 1 meter, mass of the fuel 4.25 kg per hour, calorific mean effective pressure, indicated mean effective pressure 275 kN per meter square, calorific value of the fuel 43,000 kJ per kilogram, air fuel ratio 32, temperature of the room, air temperature in the room 15 degree Celsius, and the gas temperature 370 degree Celsius. We calculate the indicated power. IP equal to PIM pi by 4 D square L into N by 60 into K. So for a two stroke cycle engine, for every revolution there will be a power stroke. So N by 60. So IP equal to substituting numerical values 275 into pi by 4 into 0.21 square into 0.28 into 350 by 60 into 1 equal to 15.55 kilowatts. And we calculate the brake power. Brake power equal to BP equal 2 pi n W into R, 2 pi nt by 60. So torque equal to W into R. So 2 pi n W into R divided by 60. So 2 pi into 350 into 620 into radius of the brake drum 0.5 meter divided by 60 into 1000 equal to 11.4 kilowatts. Then the indicated thermal efficiency, eta I indicated thermal efficiency equal to IP by mass of the fuel into calorific value. So this is 15.5 into 3600 divided by 4.25 into 43,000 into 100 equal to 30.63%. And the brake thermal efficiency equal to brake power divided by MF into CV mass of the fuel into calorific value. So 11.4 into 3600 divided by 4.25 into 43,000 into 100 equal to 22.46%. And the mass of the gas equal to mass of the air plus mass of the fuel. So mass of the fuel into mass of the air divided by mass of the fuel plus 1. So mass of the air plus mass of the air by mass of the fuel is the air fuel ratio, which is given as 32. So 4.25 into 32 plus 1, which is 140.25 kilograms per hour, which is 0.039 kilograms per second mass of the gas. Then percentage of heat loss in the exhaust gases, Qg equal to Mg into Cpg into Tg minus Ta divided by mass of the fuel into calorific value. So 0.039 into 1 into 370 minus 15, Tg equal to 370 and Ta equal to 15 degree Celsius divided by 4.25 divided by 3600 to convert the fuel consumption kilograms per second. So into 43,000 into 100 equal to 27.3%. So the answer to the problem, indicated power is 15.55 kilowatts, Brake power equal to 11.4 kilowatts. Indicated thermal efficiency is 30.67%. Brake thermal efficiency is 22.46%. And the percentage of heat loss to the exhaust gas is 27.3%. So, we take the example number 15 from May 2013 question paper. A 6-cylinder 4-stroke gasoline engine having a bore of 90 mm and the stroke length of 100 mm has a compression ratio of 7. Relative efficiency is 55% when the indicated specific fuel consumption is 300 grams per kilowatt hour. Find the calorific value of the fuel and the corresponding fuel consumption. Given that the IMEP indicated mean effective pressure is 8.5 bar and the speed equal to 2500 rpm. So, the given data, so number of cylinders equal to 6, it is a 4-stroke cycle engine, diameter equal to 0.09 meter, length equal to stroke length equal to 0.1 meter, compression ratio R equal to 7, relative efficiency is 0.55, specific fuel consumption is 0.3 kilograms per kilowatt hour, indicated mean effective pressure is 8.5 bar, speed equal to 2500 rpm. We calculate the air standard efficiency, eta A equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 1 minus 1 by 7 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 0.541. So, the indicated thermal efficiency, so from the relative efficiency, we calculate the indicated thermal efficiency. So, indicated thermal efficiency equal to relative efficiency into air standard efficiency. So, 0.55 into 0.541 equal to 0.2975 and the indicated power. So, indicated power we calculate IP equal to PIM pi by 4 D square L into N by 2 into 60. So, this is a 4-stroke cycle engine. So, divide by 2 into 60 into K is the number of cylinders. So, we are given 8.5 bar, so which is 850 kilopascal into pi by 4 into 0.09 square. Diameter is 0.09 square and the stroke length is 0.1. So, speed equal to 2500 divided by 2 into 60 into number of cylinders equal to 6. So, calculating indicated power is 67.56 kilowatts. Then the calorific value of the fuel, we calculate the calorific value of the fuel from the definition of indicated thermal efficiency. So, we are given indicated thermal efficiency equal to IP by MF into CV. So, I take the IP to the denominator, that will become MF by IP, which is SFC, specific fuel consumption. So, 1 by specific fuel consumption into the calorific value. So, now the calorific value, rearranging the terms, calorific value equal to 1 by SFC into indicated thermal efficiency. So, which is 3600 divided by 0.3 into 0.2975 equal to 40,472.2 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mass of the fuel, so from the definition of SFC, we calculate the mass of the fuel. Mass of the fuel equal to SFC into indicated power. So, 0.3 into 67.56 equal to 20.268 kilograms per hour. So, the answer to the problem, calorific value of the fuel is 42,472.2 kilojoules per kilogram and mass of the fuel is 20.268 kilograms per hour. We take the next problem, problem number 16, example number 16 from May 2007 question paper. A 4-cylinder, 4-stroke petrol engine, 6 cm bore and 9 cm stroke was tested at constant speed. The fuel supply was fixed to 0.13 kilograms per minute. And the plugs of the 4 cylinders were successfully short-circuited without change in the speed. The power measurements were as follows. With all the cylinders working 16.25 kilowatts, with the number 1 cylinder cutoff 11.55 kilowatts, with the number 2 cylinder cutoff 11.65 kilowatts, with the number 3 cylinder cutoff 11.7 kilowatts, with the number 4 cylinder cutoff 11.5 kilowatts. Find the indicated power of the engine, mechanical efficiency, indicated thermal efficiency, if the calorific value of the fuel is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram, relative efficiency on IP basis, indicated power basis, assuming clearance volume is 65 cubic centimeter. So, it is a Mohs test. So, Mohs test is conducted for calculating the indicated power of the individual cylinders of the multi-cylinder engine. So, it is actually Mohs test is used to calculate the friction power of the multi-cylinder engine. So, the data given here, number of cylinder equal to 4, K equal to 4, it is a 4-stroke cycle engine, diameter equal to 0.06 meter, bore length, stroke length equal to 0.09 meter, mass of the fuel is 0.13 kilograms per minute, brake power when all the cylinders are working 16.25 kilowatts, BP1, first cylinder is cut off 11.55 kilowatts. Second cylinder cut off BP2 equal to 11.65 kilowatts. BP3, third cylinder is cut off 11.7 kilowatts. Fourth cylinder cut off BP4 equal to 11.5 kilowatts. Calorific value of the fuel is 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram. And the clearance volume VC equal to 65 cubic centimeter. We calculate the stroke volume. So, VS equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So, this pi by 4 d square into L in terms of centimeter cube, we calculate in terms of centimeter cube, pi by 4 into 6 square into 9 equal to 254.34 centimeter cube. So, we calculate the indicated power of the engine. So, IP1. So, from the definition of most test, IP1 equal to BP minus BP1, which is 16.25 minus 11.55 equal to 4.7 kilowatts. IP2 of the second cylinder, indicated power of the second cylinder, BP minus BP2 equal to 16.25 minus 11.65 equal to 4.6 kilowatts. IP3, indicated power of the third cylinder, BP minus BP3 equal to 16.25 minus 11.7 equal to 4.55 kilowatts. IP4, indicated power of the fourth cylinder equal to BP minus BP4 equal to 16.25 minus 11.5 equal to 4.75 kilowatts. So, the total indicated power of all the four cylinders, IP equal to IP1 plus IP2 plus IP3 plus IP4. So, calculating 4.7 plus 4.6 plus 4.55 plus 4.75 equal to 18.6 kilowatts. Now, we calculate the mechanical efficiency. Mechanical efficiency, brake power by indicated power. So, which is 16.25 divided by 18.6 into equal to a 0.873. So, the efficiency is 87.3%. And we calculate the indicated thermal efficiency. So, indicated thermal efficiency is indicated power divided by mass of the fuel into calorific value. So, 18.6 divided by 2.17 into 10 power minus 3 into 42,000, which is 0.204, which is 20.4%. So, indicated thermal efficiency is 20.4%. We calculate the compression ratio from the given value of stroke volume and the clearance volume. So, 254.34 plus 65 divided by 65 equal to 4.9. Then we calculate the aspirant efficiency. So, eta A equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 1 minus 1 by 4.9 to the power 0.4 equal to 0.47, which is 47%. Relative efficiency with respect to indicated thermal efficiency. So, eta R equal to indicated thermal efficiency divided by aspirant efficiency, which is 0.204 divided by 0.47 equal to 0.434. Which is 43.4%. So, the answer to the problem, indicated power of the engine 18.6 kilowatts, mechanical efficiency is 87.3%, indicated thermal efficiency is 20.4%, and relative efficiency on the basis of indicated thermal efficiency is 43.4%. We take the next example. Example number 17 from May 2010 question paper. During the trial of 60 minutes on a single cylinder oil engine having the cylinder diameter 300 mm, stroke length 450 mm, working on 4 stroke cycle, the following observations were made. The total fuel used is 9.6 liters, calorific value of the fuel 45,000 kilojoules per kilogram, total number of revolution 12,624. Gross indicated mean effective pressure 7.24 bar, pumping indicated mean effective pressure 0.34 bar, net load on the brake 3150 newton, diameter on the brake, diameter of the brake drum 0.78 meter, diameter of the rope 40 millimeter, cooling water circulated 545 liters, cooling water temperature rise 25 degrees Celsius, specific gravity of the oil 0.8, determined indicated power, brake power and mechanical efficiency. So, we write down the given data. So, diameter equal to 0.3 meter, stroke length equal to 0.45 meter. It is a 4 stroke cycle engine. Mass of the fuel 9.6 liters per hour, 60 minutes equal to 1 hour. So, 9.6 liters per hour. Calorific value 45,000 kilojoules per kilogram. Speed equal to 12,624 revolutions per hour. Indicated mean effective pressure is 7.24 bar. The pumping power, pumping mean effective pressure is 0.34 bar. So, load is 3150 newton. Diameter of the brake drum 0.78 meter. Diameter of the rope 0.04 meter. mass of the water circulated 545 liters per hour, temperature rise of the water 25 degrees Celsius, specific gravity of the oil 0.8 and the time is 60 minutes, which is 1 hour. So, we are given two mean effective pressure, gross indicator mean effective pressure and the pumping indicator mean effective pressure. So, the net indicator mean effective pressure is 7.24 minus 0.34 equal to 6.9 bar. Now, we calculate the indicated power, IP equal to PIM pi by 4 D square into L into N by 2 into 3600, because the N is given in revolutions per hour, so into number of cylinders. So, 6.9 bar, which is 690 kilopascal, so 690 into pi by 4 into 0.3 square into 0.45, 12,624 divided by 2, so for 4 stroke cycle engine into 3600 into number of cylinder equal to 1. So, 38.46 kilowatts. Then the effective brake radius, effective radius of the brake drum. So, we are given diameter of the brake drum and diameter of the rope. So, from the to calculate the effective radius of the brake drum, diameter of the drum plus 2 times the diameter of the rope divided by 2. So, 0.78, 2 into 0.04 divided by 2 equal to 0.43 meters. Now, the brake power equal to 2 pi nt by 3600. So, 3600 to convert into, speed, revolutions per hour to second, revolutions per second. So, 2 pi into n into w into re, torque equal to w, load into radius of the brake drum, divided by 3600. So, 2 pi into 12,624 into 3150 into 0.43 divided by 3600 divided into 1000. So, this 1000 for converting power into kilowatts. So, this gives 29.83 kilowatts. So, calculating the value, you will get 29.83 kilowatts. Then we calculate the mechanical efficiency. So, brake power by indicator power, mechanical efficiency, brake power by indicator power. So, 29.83 divided by 38.46 equal to 77.56%. So, the answer to the problem, indicator power is 38.46 kilowatts. Brake power is 29.83 kilowatts and mechanical efficiency is 77.56%. And the next example, example number 18 from May 2013 question paper. The following observations were taken during a test on a single cylinder 4 stroke cycle engine having bore 300 mm, stroke 450 mm, ambient temperature 27 degrees Celsius, fuel consumption 11 kilograms per hour, calorific value of the fuel 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram, engine speed 300 rpm, mean effective pressure 6 bar, net brake load 1 kN, brake drum diameter 2 meter, quantity of jacket cooling water 590 kilograms per hour, temperature of entering cooling water 22 degrees Celsius, temperature of leaving cooling water 70 degrees Celsius, quantity of air consumed 225 kilograms per hour, specific heat of the exhaust gases 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, exhaust gas temperature 405 degrees Celsius, rope diameter 2 cm, determine indicated power, brake power, mechanical efficiency and draw a heat balance sheet on the hour basis. So, we write down the given data. So, it is a 4 stroke cycle engine, diameter of the cylinder 0.3 meter, stroke length is 0.45 meter, ambient temperature is 22 degrees Celsius, mass of the fuel 11 kilograms per hour, calorific value 42,000 kilojoules per kilogram, speed 3000 rpm, n equal to 3000 rpm, indicated mean effective pressure 6 bar, load 1 kN, diameter of the brake drum D equal to 2 meter, mass of the water 590 kilograms per hour, inlet temperature of the water 22 degrees Celsius, outlet temperature of the water 70 degrees Celsius, mass of the air 225 kilograms per hour, specific heat of the gases 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, gas temperature 405 degrees Celsius, rope diameter 0.02 meter, dr equal to 0.02 meter. So, first we calculate the indicated power. So, IP equal to PIM pi by 4 d square L into n by 2 into 60 into k. We substitute the numerical values 600, 6 bar 600 kilopascal, pi by 4 into 0.3 square into 0.45. It is 300 rpm. So, 300 divided by 2 into 60 into 1 single cylinder engine. So, indicated power equal to 47.69 kilowatts. We calculate the effective radius of the brake drum, RE equal to diameter of the drum plus 2 into diameter of the rope divided by 2. So, 2 plus 2 into 0.02 divided by 2 equal to 1.02 meter. And we calculate the brake power. So, brake power equal to 2 pi nt by 60. So, 2 pi n into w into re divided by 60. So, substituting numerical values, 2 pi into n equal to 300 rpm, w equal to 1 kilonewton, and the effective radius 1.02 divided by 60 equal to 32.03 kilowatts. We calculate the mechanical efficiency equal to brake power by indicator power. So, substituting numerical values, 32.03 divided by 47.69 into 100 equal to 67.16%. Then we calculate the, we go for the heat balance sheet on the hour basis. For heat balance test, first we have to calculate the amount of heat supplied. So, heat supplied equal to MF into CV, 11 into 42,000 equal to 462,000 kilojoules per hour. So, in terms of kilojoules per hour, we calculate on hourly basis, 462,000 kilojoules per hour, which is considered as 100%. Then, heat equivalent to brake power. So, brake power already we calculated in kilowatts. Kilowatts is kilojoules per second. So, BP into 3600. So, 32.03 into 3600 equal to 115,308 kilojoules per hour. So, the efficiency in percentage. So, QBP divided by QS into 100. So, 115,308 divided by 462,000 into 100 equal to 24.96. So, 24.96 percentage of heat energy is utilized for the brake power. Then, heat carried away by the cooling water, QW equal to MW CPW into TW2 minus TW1. So, MW it is given as 590 kilograms per hour. CPW specific heat of water 4.187 is a constant. TW2 is 70 degrees Celsius. TW1 equal to 22 degrees Celsius. Calculating, this is 118,575.84 kilojoules per hour. In percentage, we calculate QW by QS into 100. So, 118,575.84 divided by 462,000 into 100 equal to 25.67%. So, in the total amount of heat produced by burning the fuel, 25.67% is carried away by the water. Then, heat carried away by the gases. So, QG equal to MG plus CPG into MG into CPG into TG minus TA. So, mass of the gas equal to mass of the air plus mass of the fuel. So, we are given 225 kilograms per hour of air and 11 kilogram per hour of fuel. So, 225 plus 11. Specific heat is 1.005 given in the problem. Tg equal to 405, Ta equal to 22. Calculating 98,39.94 kilojoules per hour. And in percentage, the amount of heat carried away by the gases, Qg by Qs into 100. So, 98,39.94 divided by 462,000 into 100 equal to 19.66%. So, in the total amount of heat produced by burning the fuel, 19.66% is carried away by the exhaust gases. The remaining losses are accounted as unaccounted, heat unaccounted. So, heat unaccounted equal to the total heat supplied minus all the heat utilization, Q brake power, Q water and Q gas. So, 100 minus in terms of percentage. So, QBP 24.96, QW 25.67, QG 19.66. So, heat unaccounted is 29.71%. So, in terms of kilojoules per hour, so 0.2971 into 462,000, which is 137,260.2 kilojoules per hour. So, we calculated everything as per the given data. Now, we draw the heat balance sheet. So, this is the heat balance sheet. So, we have heat supplied at one side and heat used in the other side. So, heat supplied by burning the fuel, which is 462,000 kilojoules per hour, which is considered as 100%. So, we write down the heat utilization on the other side. So, the QBP 115,308, which is 24.96%. Heat carried away by the water 118,575.84, which is 25.67%. Heat carried away by the exhaust gases 90,839.94, which is 19.66%. And heat unaccounted 137,260.20. Which is 29.71%. So, the vertical totaling is 462,000 and here it is 100%. So, this is what the heat balance sheet. So, we have to prepare the heat balance sheet based on the data given. And the Other answers, indicated power is 49.69 kilowatts, brake power is 32.03 kilowatts and mechanical efficiency is 67.16%. So, we stop here. So, these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. You can also refer to it. And these are all the books I published. So, design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel, so where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here, and the video lectures on solution to the gate question paper is also uploaded. And here you find a book on thermal engineering is also available. You can refer to the book for additional problems, and you can use the videos for your better learning and pass in the gate examination. The using the video, subscribing the channel and using the video, it is absolutely free, so you can use it for your better learning. Thank you for watching. You can please post your comments on the YouTube comments box. You please subscribe the channel for your better learning, and you can write to me to my mail ID or WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. So thank you. We'll meet again in another video with additional problems in the IC engine.